Hello, my name is Rickard, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a cast shadow effect on text in Photoshop. In the course of this tutorial, you'll also learn some tricks on blending to make text look realistic, and also how to roughen the edges to make it look hand-painted. If you want to follow along, I have included all the assets in a link in the description of this video. Go ahead, download those, and then let's dive into Photoshop. All right, I'm gonna go to File, Open. I'm gonna open the Felicia file. This file is very big in terms of resolution. Just gonna make working with type a little problematic. So I'm just gonna go to File, Image Size, and change the resolution here to 300. I wanna make sure Resample is not checked. That way, all it's doing is changing my inch dimensions. It's not actually changing the resolution of the image so much as how many pixels make up an inch. So let's hit OK there. Next, I'm going to go into my Type tool. And for this, I'm going to use the font Brandon Grotesque Black. And if you don't have that, just click right here. You can go to Adobe Fonts and activate it. For a point size, I'm gonna do 300, and then I'm just gonna click somewhere here in the middle and type in Nucly. What I wanna do is make this have a cast shadow. And what I mean by that is a shadow that doesn't step in any way. So it's just a basically like a 45 degree straight angle of this text. So the way to do that is meticulously and painfully repeating the same pixels over and over again. So let's go ahead and make a selection of the transparency by holding down Command and clicking on the layer thumbnail. You can see now my letters are selected. I'm going to go ahead and make a new layer, and we'll call this Shadow. And I'm gonna fill this with black. So let's go ahead, fill, and we wanna fill with black. Let's hit okay. All right, then I wanna deselect. And basically, if I just did a normal shadow, it would look something like this. The problem is, I want this filled in. Like this triangle right here, I want filled in. So how do we do that? Well, the way we're gonna do that is basically moving our shadow one pixel down and one pixel to the left. Then we're gonna make a copy of it and do that again, 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 again. Basically do it 10 times. Once we have it 10 times, then we're gonna do the same thing, but with all 10 copies. So here you can see I now have 10 copies. What I'm gonna do is put all those together like this, by selecting them all and doing Command E. And I'm not gonna rename, I'm not gonna continually rename this because we're gonna keep making more copies. But now what I can do is make a copy and hold down Shift when I go down and to the left. Now because it's 10 copies and Shift moves my layer by 10 pixels, this will still work. So now I can make another copy, do it again. And then you can do this as many times as you want, depending on how big you want your cast shadow to be. So for this, let's zoom out here. I think maybe just a little more. I think like that looks good. All right, so now we're going to copy all those. Let's go shadow. And I want the shadow to be just the shadow, meaning I don't want the text. So I'm going to hold down Command and then delete that from my shadow layer. So now if I turn off Nucly, you'll see this is just the shadow. And next thing I want to do is just roughen up this edge, make it look a little more hand-painted. And the way I'm going to do that is by first turning this into a mask. So I'm going to hold down Command, select this layer thumbnail again, and that's going to select my transparency. With my transparency selected, I'm going to go here and add a solid color. And because I have a selection active, it's going to turn that into a mask. All right, here, just select any color I want. I can always go back and change this. But for now, I'll just select a deep red color. All right, and then with my mask selected, and if I want to see what I'm doing, I can hold down Option and click on the mask, and that'll isolate it in my viewfinder here. All right, so I'm going to go to Filter Gallery, and under Brush Strokes, I'm going to use the Splatter effect. You can see what that's doing. It's just giving a nice roughness to my edges here. And I want the smoothness all the way to 15, but you can adjust the radius here depending on the size of your text and also how rough you want the edges to be. I find between 15 and 20 is good. So let's go 15 and hit OK. All right, next, I want to smooth this. And this, you're now going to see the advantage of having this on a mask, is I can double click on it, go into my Select and Mask dialog, and add some smoothness. So here, I'm going to add, let's say, 60 of smoothness, which is doing exactly what I want it to do, but it is adding also a little bit of blur to the edge. So I'm going to counteract that by adding 50% contrast here, and that'll just get rid of that feathering. So let's hit OK. That's going to right away just apply it to my mask there, and I think that looks really good. All right, next, I want to do the same thing to the Nucly text. So I'm going to go through the basic same steps. I'm going to select my transparency, turn that off, add a solid color layer. That's going to add my mask. I'll make this like a more yellow golden color. And then we're going to run through the same steps on the mask itself. So I'm going to go up to here. Because I haven't run any filter since I did my last one, I actually am just going to use this up here, which repeats the last filter that you ran with exactly the same settings. So there you go. That's going to roughen up my edges. I can double click in here and apply the same smoothness settings. So we'll do 60 and 50. And then hit OK. Okay, and then to just increase the look of this being hand painted, I'm going to go to my shadow layer, and we can name these now, shadow and text. And on my shadow layer, I'm just going to do Command T for transform and just rotate this a tiny bit, like less than 1 degree here, and then just move it a few pixels to the left. And what that's going to do is it's just going to make it look a little more hand painted, like someone used two stencils and didn't quite line them up perfectly. All right, next, I want to make this look like it's on the wood itself. And rather than using a blending mode to do that, none of which are going to give me quite the effect that I want, I'm going to use blending options or blend if. To do that, I'm going to double click on the layer here. That's going to bring up these blend if options. I'm just going to move this here so you can see the effect that it's having. Okay, so down here under blend if, you have blending between the two layers. And what this is basically saying is this layer underneath, anything that is in this area of the histogram, I want to blend through the top layer. Similarly, anything that's in this part of the histogram, meaning in the light area of the histogram, I want to blend through this top layer. And you can see the effect that that's having there. So for this, for wood, what I want to do is I want to, all these kind of breaks in the blue paint, I want showing through. So right as the blue starts disappearing, I'm going to push it back to the right. And then hold down Option and just split this point. And that prevents, this basically just creates a feather. So with them together, it's going to be a very hard clip. And by feathering them a bit, you're going to have a little more of a transition between the two. So something like that. And then I also want these darker lines between the planks to not show through. So let's push this. You can see that here. It's having the effect that I want. So somewhere around there, you can see as it starts to get rid of too much of this blue, I'm going to pull it back. And then again, just split that. Okay. All right, now I want the same effect on the yellow letters. I could repeat all my blend if options, but a good trick here is you can actually right mouse click and go down to copy layer styles, and that'll also copy your blend if options. And then here I can paste layer style. So there you go. Now I have my wood texture showing through. I also want a little bit of wood texture on top of the letters. So to do that, I'm going to take my background layer, copy it, pull it to the top here, and then go to Image Adjustments, Black and White. And I'm going to adjust the blues here. You can kind of see you want the histogram information to reside mostly in the middle of your histogram. So as I move this to the left, you can see the histograms moving to the left and to the right. I want this right about in the middle. So I'm just looking at my histogram here, moving this about until it sits right about in the middle. So right there, and then hit OK. And the reason you want the histogram in the middle for any layer that you're going to use on overlay is it's going to prevent your overlay pushing the colors too much in one direction, like making them too light or too dark. If the histogram is in the middle, it's going to make certain parts darker, certain parts lighter. That's what you want. So let's put this on overlay. And then I'm going to hold down Option and click between so that this is only affecting my Nucly text layer. And then hold down Option, make a copy of it, do the same thing there. And you can see the effect that that's having. It's making it just look like some of that wood grain texture is seeping through onto the paint itself. And pretty happy with that. Now, the one thing I also want to show you is that you can automate some of these things. And I actually have some actions that do this as part of my Nucly action set. And the advantage with that is all those steps that, you know, we just spent the last 10 minutes doing, I can do in a few seconds. So let's go ahead and turn these off. Let's change this to action. And here I'm just going to go to my action and click on the cast shadows. You can see that that is going to start my cast shadow effect. I can just keep pushing the action and it'll just keep making the same shadow deeper and deeper. And once I have it to about the length that I want, I'm just going to go here, copy all these, hold down Command D to merge them, delete that. And then I'm going to run the roughen edges. And that is going to both roughen the edges and it's going to create my mask, so I can do it for both layers. Like so. And then just assign my colors here by double clicking on the solid color. Like so. And then do my little 1 degree trick here for the rotation. Maybe move that a little bit. Oh, that's a little too much, I think. Yeah, something like this. And then I can copy my layer style here onto both of these. And then also copy these. And there you go. You can see changing the text is relatively easy. So there you have it. That's how you create that effect in Photoshop. And if you want to speed up that process, I have included a link to the actions I mentioned toward the end of the tutorial. If you enjoyed this, please subscribe to my channel, leave a like, leave a comment, share this video, do all that good stuff, and here's some other videos to check out. I'll see you next time.